What is SMARTV3? For your information, UMS SMARTV3 is a learning management system that is complementary to traditional or conventional learning systems. It offers an online learning environment and provides students with easy access to materials and tools for learning. Anytime, wherever you want, you can access it using any device, like you can use your smartphone, laptop, PC, or tablet. SMARTV3 has the purpose of creating activities to develop the understanding of students, as well as e-assessment activities such as projects, forums, and quizzes. Now, I will teach you how to log in into your SMARTV3 account. Open your browser, then go to the official website of SMARTUMS. The link is smartv3.ums.edu.my. Then click Enter. This is the main page of the official website of SMARTUMS. On the top, you will see the announcement section. When you scroll down, you will see on the left the navigation section, the activities section, and the course categories. If you want to log in into your account, on the top, go to the right side, you will see the login button. Then click the button. Now, you are in the login page. If you still new or first time user, the username will be your matric number and the password is your identity card number or your IC number. To make your account more secure, you are recommended to change the password by yourself. Just go to preferences and click change password. Now, enter your username, which is your matric number. And your password is your IC number. Then click login. Now you are successfully logging into your account.
Hi everyone, I'm gonna show you on how to enroll and unenroll yourself on SMARTUMS. It is important for you to enroll yourself to the course because you need to be up to date to the course announcement, lecture notes, the works and assignment given by the lecturers, and you need to submit your works on SMARTUMS. You also need to unenroll yourself from the course you were wrongly enrolled in order to avoid confusion in the future when you have started your study. Okay, now I'm going to show you on how to enroll yourself. As you can see right now, you are on the dashboard page. In order for you to find your course, you need to look on the top left side. Here, you can see the home button. Click on it. You'll be taken to the home page and scroll down until you see the search courses. You need to enter your courses code or its name. So here I'm just gonna put the course code and click go. Here you will see the course with different section, and what you need to do is click on the course you have registered on SMPUMS. Make sure the section is correct too, as registered on SMP. Then you will be taken to the enrollment option. Scroll down to the self-enrollment student. Here you simply click on enroll me. However, some courses might need enrollment key. But here you just need to click on enroll me. Congratulate yourself. You already enrolled yourself to the course and you can start your study. Next, I'm gonna show you on how to unenroll yourself from the subject. Firstly, what you need to do is, on the top left side, click on my course and type on the course you would like to unenroll yourself. You will be taken to the course page. Scroll down until you see the administration part. here to unenroll yourself, just click on unenroll me from Katie's 14303 section 1, and you are on the confirmation page. Just simply click continue. Finally, you already have unenrolled yourself from the course.
When you are in the dashboard, you will see the course overview. There are two ways to view this page, which are by timeline or courses. If you click on the timeline, you will see the assignments and quizzes for all courses that you have registered. They are grouped in overdue, next 7 days, next 30 days, and future. Next, when you click on the courses, you will see all the courses that you have registered, and if you notice, there is a percentage on the left side of each courses. This indicates your progress on that particular courses. For example, if I click on this subject, and I have finished homework 1 and 2, I can tick these boxes. And you will notice that the percentage will change. When you click any courses in the dashboard, you will see this course here. There are several options here, but the most important thing that you have to know is the grade, assignment, and quizzes.
Once you log in, go to the dashboard and then click any of your course to check if there an assignment and quizzes that your lecturer gave. Next, how to submit your assignment. Once you log in to your assignment, you will see the descriptions of your assignment and also the submission status. From the submission status, you can see the due date of your assignment and then the time remaining of your assignment. After read all the description, just click the add submission, scroll down, and then you will see where the place to submit your assignment. After drop your file, just click the button save change to submit your assignment. Next is how to see your grades. Go again to the dashboard and then click the grades for any assignment that you have been submit, and then you can see your grades for the assignment.
Moving on to the next part, namely additional features. So in additional features, I'll be sharing about two important things, which are upcoming events and calendar. Firstly, I'll be talking about upcoming events. So SMARTV3 allows UMS students to get the newest information of any events effectively. For instance, once we enter the main page, we will be updated about upcoming events on top or header of the page. The upcoming events will be shown continuously through moving slides. Next, below the header is the site announcements. There will be graphics like posters or pictures regarding the upcoming events to notify students and lecturers. Date, phone number, and email address related to the upcoming events are usually in the site announcements for future references. Help desk information and operation hours are provided for students who have any concerns or inquiries. Secondly is calendar. SMARTV3 is pleased to provide students with a calendar to remind them about that submission for all courses. In order to view the calendar, students need to click their name on the top right side and find the calendar located under preferences. Besides that, students could also view their calendar on the left side by clicking Site Pages. Click on the calendar and we could see our courses that submission have been listed and highlighted. Other than that, we also could add events manually on the calendar by clicking on the New Event button.
On the top of the right side will be our name, and after clicking it, there will be other pages, and one of them is Preferences located under Grades. Once we click on the Preferences, we will enter the Preferences page, and there will be many choices such as User Account, Blocks, and Page. Notification and Message. Notification and message settings are located in the User Account button, and once we click on the Notification Preferences, we will see there are different kinds of notification that we will change. We could choose whether to turn on or turn them off for web and email. Students need to make sure that their official UMS email address is registered for system auto notification. This notification or message setting will help to notify students with their lesson, forums, and more. Students will be able to catch up with the newest information from their lecturer.